scientist. Are you ready for a virtual field trip? From sunny Los Angeles, let's go to the California Science Center with your hosts, Mariela and Monica, with a special appearance from
Crystal Gentle.
Let's go to the California Science Center.
Hi scientists, welcome to virtual field trips at the California Science Center. Before we get started, there are a few things we need to go over. All virtual field trips will have a question of the day. And today's question is,
how do parents make sure their babies stay alive? Pause the video now to write down the question of the day in your notebooks. And don't forget to write or draw things you observe in the video to help you answer the question.
All virtual field trips will also have a buzzword. Today's buzzword is
pattern. Anytime you hear this word, be sure to make check marks or tally marks somewhere in your notebook to keep track of how many times you hear the buzzword.
Before I forget, there may be times we might ask you to pause to think about a question. You'll see this sign and hear this sound to remind you to pause. Okay, I think we're ready for a virtual field trip. Let's go!
Scientists, I wanted to start here in this library to show some books that I've been reading. If you notice, they are about plants and animals. In science, scientists are always looking for patterns around them to understand what is going on, like patterns on leaves, in sunsets, and sunrises, and between adult dogs and their babies. We don't just look for patterns in colors or numbers, but we use patterns to understand how things work. I've been learning about parents and baby plants and animals, and in my books, I'm noticing patterns. The baby plant or animal have some way that they look similar to their parents. All this reading has me wondering if the California Science Center has parents and babies we can see. I know a place we can explore our question. Let's go. Now, I'm guessing that when you heard the words parent and baby, you began to think about animals and their cute babies. But my first thought brought us here, to the greenhouse at the California Science Center. Now this place is special because not everybody can come here, but this greenhouse is where scientists are making sure that plants are getting what they need to survive. Many of the plants that start here are very small. They are baby plants. The California Science Center is growing these plants to add to our exhibits. Let's take a closer look at this dwarf banana plant. I know it may look big, but this plant is a baby or young plant. What are some things that you notice? Are all the colors on the plant the same? What about the shape of the leaves? How do these compare to other leaves you've seen? I wonder how long the leaves are. Maybe we can measure them. Oh, this one is 12 inches long. What about the size of the plant? Maybe we can measure that as well. Wow, it measures 26 inches high. Let's make some more observations and see what patterns we might find. Let's keep in mind what we saw here and see if we can notice patterns of things it has in common with the older plant. Scientists, are you wondering what that young dwarf banana plant looks like as an adult? Follow me this way. Ah, here it is. This is what the baby plant will look like as an adult. What are some things you notice with the adult plant? What is that growing on it? Are all the colors the same? Let's start with the leaves like we did with the baby. Let's measure the leaves on this adult plant. Wow, 24 inches long. The leaves of the adult are about as large as the entire baby dwarf banana plant. I wonder how tall this adult plant is. Oh, it's 52 inches tall, much taller than the baby plant. Now that we have both plants side by side, what are some patterns that you notice? What do these two plants have in common? Does the baby plant look like the parent plant? Wow, scientists! I noticed so many patterns between the baby and parent plants. I wonder if we could find patterns in animals. I know an animal we can observe. Let's go. Scientists, here we have the next parent we're going to observe. This is an anole lizard. Let's make some observations of this parent. What do you notice? What color are the anoles? I wonder how long these adult anoles are. Oh, they're about 10 inches long. What do you notice about their tails? Remember, we want to find patterns between the parent and babies. And since we haven't seen the baby anole, we need to make those observations of this parent and notice as many details as we can. I have a surprise, scientist. I'm going to take you behind the scenes again to find the baby anoles. Let's go. This is a baby anole. What do you see? Remember, we want to find patterns, ways that the babies are similar to the parents. Let's measure it. Wow, this one is about 4 to 6 inches long. What color are these baby anoles? Do their bodies look like their parents? I'm starting to see how baby plants and animals are similar to their parents. I'm thinking we can catch up with someone else that can help us find more parents and babies here at the California Science Center.
Aquarius here at the California Science Center. We're currently in front of our kelp forest exhibit, and I'm here to tell you about baby fish, or what scientists like to call juvenile fish, and their parents, and see how similar or how different they are. In the ocean, there are lots of animals that lay eggs, and from some of those eggs we can get baby fish that can look very different from their parents. Then there are some fish that give live birth, just like our pile surf perch. Those baby fish look like mini copies of their parents. And unlike humans, who take care of their babies, surf perch fish do not. Once the babies are born, they have to learn to live on their own. In order to protect our surf perch babies here at the California Science Center from predators in our kelp forest, we separate the babies into smaller tanks, where we feed them and watch over them until they're old enough and big enough to join the other fish in our kelp forest exhibit.
What are some patterns you notice between the baby and the adult pile perch? Now, what are some other patterns you notice between these babies and the adults?
Thank you for joining me today on our science talk about baby fish. I hope to see you around.
Scientists, today we are going to sing a song with some of my friends. Let me introduce you to them. These are the Science Songbirds. They want to share a song about parents and their offspring, or babies. Some animals take great care of their babies, while other animal babies don't even need their mom or dad. There are lots of ways animals might take care of their babies. Let's look at some animals and see if we can figure out how.
What do you see in this picture? How is the mother dog caring for her puppies? How about this? Do you see the baby birds with their mouths open? What is their mother doing? What about this mouse and its baby? Can you see what's happening? So what do all these pictures have in common? The parents are feeding their babies. Scientists call babies offspring. And here to teach us a song about parents and their offspring are our very own science songbirds. Listen to the science songbirds and try to sing along.
Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. They give them food to eat. They give them food to eat. They give them food to eat. Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. They give them food to eat.
Great job! Now let's look at some more animals taking care of their offspring. Look carefully. What do you see in this picture? How about these elephants? Can you see how they're gathering around the baby? Why do they do that? This bird is called a killdeer. Can you see how it's protecting its eggs? How are all these parents in the pictures taking care of their babies? They are keeping them safe. Parents take care of their offspring by protecting them from danger. Science songbirds, do you have something to say about that?
Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. Protect them from danger. Protect them from danger. Protect them from danger. Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. Protect them from danger.
Beautiful. Now, let's take a look at a few more animal families. Look at this mama bear and her cub. What is the cub doing? Is he trying to climb over the log? What do you think his mother is doing? How about this moose? Do you think the baby knows how to cross the river on its own? Parents teach their babies many skills they need to survive. Take it away, science songbirds!
Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. They teach them lots of skills. They teach them lots of skills. They teach them lots of skills. Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. They teach them lots of skills.
And last but not least, let's look at a few more animals. What do you see in these pictures? All these babies are snuggling up with their mamas. Even wild animals show affection to their offspring, hugging them, rubbing heads with them, playing with them, even cleaning them. You know the song by now. Join the science songbirds for our last verse.
Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. They love them very much. They love them very much. They love them very much. Parents take care of their offspring. Parents take care of their babies. Parents take care of their offspring. They love them very much.
That was fun, scientists. Let's head back to the discovery room.
What a great field trip. Let's go over all the things that we did today.
We started our field trip in a library to talk about patterns. Then we visited the greenhouse to make observations of a young dwarf banana plant. That led us to make observations of the parent plant and made side-by-side observations. We then made observations of parent and baby anole lizards and found that both baby and parents look very similar. Finally, we sang a song with Mariela and the science songbirds about how parents help their offspring survive.
Do you remember the question of the day? Can you use the buzzword to answer the question of the day?
Pause the video now to try to answer the question of the day using the buzzword.
How do parents make sure their babies stay alive? Okay, scientists, it's time to count our check marks. How many times did you hear the buzzword?
Pause the video now to count your check marks or tally marks.
Drum roll, please. And the answer is
15.
We hope you had fun on this virtual field trip at the California Science Center, and we look forward to seeing you next time.
For more virtual field trip fun, visit our website.